Welcome to Tis the Soundtrack, the channel dedicated to digging deep and bringing you the merriest of music all year long. I'm your host, Kevin Williams, and today we'll be taking a look at what's in store for the remainder of the year, our very own holiday road ahead. It's been a little over 2 months since I launched Tis the Soundtrack and accidentally fell into the world of podcasting and YouTube videos. It's been a fun journey, and I've met some really fantastic people along the way. With a few episodes under my belt and a slight investment in some actual audio equipment, so long to my kids' Razer gaming headset, I'm at the point where I can start charting a path ahead for the remainder of 2024. I'm targeting 2 episodes per month, with a few additional bits and musings sprinkled in between on the blog. I'm also trying to stick to a schedule, with new content being released at the middle and end of each month. This works out to approximately 15 episodes, not counting this one, between now and waking up Christmas morning to see what Santa has brought me. Fingers crossed it's that Sony ZV-E10 camera I've been eyeing. Or, barring that, if the big guy in red has any pull with the powers to be over at Square Enix, getting a Final Fantasy Tactics remaster released in time for the holidays would be a perfectly acceptable substitute. So, what are the plans for the next 8 months? Well, thanks for asking. I was hoping I'd remember to give myself a lead-in. Because devoting a blog and show to Christmas music isn't enough of a niche on its own, with Tis the Soundtrack, I'll be focusing on a couple of my favorite topics under the holiday music umbrella. First, we'll be spending some time exploring the music used in Christmas commercials. Advertising campaigns, Christmas or otherwise, have a unique ability to launch a new artist, propel a song from relative obscurity to cultural mainstay, or introduce a fading classic to an entirely new generation. Think of the yearly anticipation that surrounds the release of the John Lewis holiday advert, and how it will inevitably send its featured song flying up the UK charts. And I can't fight this feeling anymore. I've forgotten what I started fighting for. And in other instances, it's the music that does the heavy lifting, firmly cementing an advertisement in the social consciousness. Be honest. Can you hear handbells at Christmas time without immediately thinking of the iconic Hershey's Kisses commercial with the chocolates ringing out, "We wish you a Merry Christmas"? What's even more impressive is when said audio has nothing at all to do with Christmas, but through skillful sampling, clipping, and editing, can be shaped and contorted into something that does indeed invoke holiday magic. Take the 2005 JCPenney Unwrap the Magic campaign, for instance. It features the Electric Light Orchestra's song, Living Thing, but it pulls the phrase, "It's a giving thing," from the middle of the chorus to punctuate the commercial's theme of gift-giving.
This is the shape of the holiday season. JCPenney.com.
And if you find that even remotely interesting, stay tuned. One of the episodes slated for this year will be covering Jeff Lynne's and ELO's contributions to holiday advertisement. This brings us to the next focus of Tis the Soundtrack, non-Christmas music that has, over time, become a permanent fixture of the holiday season. And no, I'm not talking about stuff like how Deck the Halls was derived from a Welsh New Year's Eve carol. I'm talking about things like When You Wish Upon a Star from Pinocchio, which was used in the 1958 Disney Christmas special From All of Us to All of You. And while it didn't register more than a blip here in the States, in Japan and the Scandinavian countries, it has been codified as an official sound of Christmas. When you wish upon a star, make no difference who you are. Another example is Lindsey Buckingham's Holiday Road, which has the distinction of being featured in every National Lampoon's vacation movie except Christmas Vacation. And since we're talking about Christmas Vacation, let me take a moment to mention that I was recently on an episode of the Totally Rad Christmas Podcast, where Totally Rad host, fellow 80s kid, and all-around awesome human Jerry D, and I discuss the movie's bootleg soundtrack. If you haven't listened to the episode, or somehow arrived here but haven't heard of Totally Rad Christmas, I suggest you stop listening to this right now and go check it out. It's a much better use of these precious minutes, and an opportunity to listen to Jerry educate me on music theory and composition. The link is in the show notes. Okay. Back to Holiday Road. While never intended to be a festive song, and specifically omitted from the sole Christmas movie in the Vacation series, it seems to be slowly creeping into Christmas playlists. Between the internet being the bastion of less than accurate information that it is, and the song being featured in the aforementioned bootleg copy of the soundtrack, it has been loosely associated with Christmas for some time now. This transition was completed recently when country artist Chris Jansen recorded a cover version of the song, and then used it to close out this year's The Wonderful World of Disney Magical Holiday Celebration. It is now firmly part of the Christmas tapestry. Don't believe me? Here's a fun experiment. Fire up your music streaming platform of choice, locate Holiday Road, and enable autoplay or track radio station or whatever your app calls it where it auto-selects the next song. Was that next song a Christmas song? Chances are good the answer is yes. I just did this exercise myself and title-selected Darlene Love's All Alone on Christmas as the follow-up. Personally, I don't consider Holiday Road a bona fide Christmas song. To me, it falls in that Christmas-adjacent or maybe Christmas-by-proxy category. But don't take that the wrong way. This gray area happens to be home of some of my absolute favorite tracks. This might need some explanation. See, in my own home, there is a strict Christmas music season. It starts with Thanksgiving and ends with New Year's Day. No exceptions, no room for negotiation. And though I disagree wholeheartedly with this decree, I've learned that following it results in a far more amicable living situation the other 11 months of the year. To me, songs that loiter in this dubious gray area are like cheat codes. I can listen to them all day long, any time of year, and because they're not overtly Christmassy or even wintry in theme, no one's the wiser that I'm secretly getting my holiday fix. While playing something like Silver Bells in July would be tantamount to a declaration of war in my home, I can listen to Kate Miller-Heidke's Are You Ready without as much as an eyebrow raise from my always wonderful, extremely patient, yet somehow completely wrong about the seasonality of Christmas music spouse. Are you all ready? Are you ready? Get set. Are you ready? Get set. Are you ready? Are you all ready? Are you ready? Get set. Are you ready? Get set. Let's go. For those of you out there in similar life arrangements who need to keep the peace while also scratching that Christmas music itch, I've started a playlist of these Christmas by Association tunes titled Stealth Christmas. At this time, the playlist is available on both YouTube and Tidal, with new tracks being added regularly to both. Links are in the show notes. And finally, if you're unsure whether a song is too Christmassy to be played out of season, or you're worried about possibly invoking the wrath of your coworkers or living companions, Tis the Soundtrack has developed the Music Chirsmometer, a highly calibrated precision scale used to determine just how Christmas a song is. At the top of this highly attuned 5-point scale is Bing Crosby singing White Christmas, the epitome of a Christmas song. The scale progresses downward through Dean Martin's Winter Wonderland, Fleet Foxes' White Winter Hymnal, Simon and Garfunkel's Hazy Shade of Winter, and finally bottoms out with the Edgar Winter Group's Frankenstein at number one. Going forward, whenever we're discussing a song on Tis the Soundtrack, we'll make sure to run it through the Chirsmometer for an official reading. And for those curious, Holiday Road is currently reporting in at a steady 1.75 CMUs, or Christmas Melody Units. Thank you for riding along while we journey down Tis the Soundtrack's own Holiday Road. Thank you for listening to Tis the Soundtrack. This is Kevin Williams, saying cheers and Merry Christmas.